Hello guys, welcome back to my channel VFX Expert. So guys, we are going to start VFX Paint in Photoshop. So this is first class of VFX Paint in Photoshop. So in this today's class, we are going to see basic tools, timeline setting and option, and also how to define shortcut for VFX Paint in Photoshop. So let's start the class here. So guys, now we are inside Photoshop here. So here I am using Photoshop 2020 and this is our essential workspace. So simple, just you can click on workspace, then workspace and essential workspace. So first we have to import our footage. So simple, we can click on file, then click on open, then simple you can select your image sequence. Now just close this one here. Now again just I am going to run Photoshop here. So because here I am using Photoshop 2020, so here you will get this welcome window here. So you can see this is our actually Photoshop welcome window here. So now from here, suppose if you want to start your work, then simple you can click on file, then also you can click on open. So same thing we will get here. But suppose if you want to close this window, then simple again you can click on maybe workspace, then again you can select essential. So this will just close this welcome window here. Now just I am going to import our footage or image sequence here. Because here just I am going to work on image sequence or video footage. So before importing your footage, if you want, you can also enable your timeline here. So for this simple, we can click on window, then you can select this timeline here. So this will just add timeline in downside here in our this interface here. So now after this, just I'm going to import our image sequence or video footage here. So for this, we have to click on file, then we have to click on open and just select your image sequence. So now just open over this folder here. So this is our image sequence here. So just we have to select this starting frame or first frame, then downside you will get this image sequence option. Remember this one, you have to check this one, otherwise this will import only this image or this frame here. So just we have to select starting frame, then we have to click on image sequence here. Now we have to click on open here, then frame rate. You can set your frame rate according to your requirement. Maybe suppose if you want to working or maybe 24 fps or 30 fps, then simple you can set it here. But if you are working for film or movie, then you can set it here 24 here. So now just simply we can type it here 24 fps here. Now we have to click on OK here. So now here just I have imported over this image sequence inside Photoshop, and downside in over this timeline. So just a little bit adjust this panels here, so easily we can see. So this is our timelines here, and this is our actually just player controls here. So simply just click here, so you can play your image sequence inside Photoshop here. So this is our image sequence here. Event, simple you can select this playhead and just simply you can scrub here. So this is first frame, then simply you can play, stop, this is next frame, and this is previous frame. And downside, this is your actually timeline, just simple zoom in zoom out. Just you can just zoom in zoom out your timeline. Then next, this is your actually current frame, where is your playhead here. But this is actually showing in the form of time code here. If you want to change time code into frames, then simply we can click on this settings here, timeline settings. Then we can click on panel options and just simply we can change it here, frame number. So for VFX Paint, this is again important things here. So simply just we can check it here. Now press OK. So now only it's showing here frame. So easily we can jump on any frame. Suppose if you want to jump on 50 frame, then simple this is your current frame. Remember this one. Then simply you can double click here. Or just you can type any frame where you want to jump in this timeline. Now press OK here. Okay, like this you can jump on any frame into this timelines here. Now again just play and check. Now it has stopped here. So now if you want to loop this timeline, then again you can click here, then you can select this loop playback here. Now play and check again. Now you can see here. So these are our actually basic options for our this timelines here. Then next, just I am going to define shortcut for all these options here. We have to click on edit, then keyboard shortcut, then in our shortcuts for, just we have to select this panel menu. Then downside you will get about this timeline video. Remember this one, here we have to select this timeline video, then this time, next frame and previous frame. So these three shortcut we have to define it here. So these three shortcuts are very important for paint work. So first previous frame, which is F1, just simply you can type, even you can define any shortcut. Okay, so just first for previous frame you can type F1, then next frame simply click and type F2, then this time, this is actually our current time, so which is our this one here downside. So just simple, we can also define it here F3. Then we have to click on accept and click on OK here. Now simple, press F1, so this will move previous frame or back, then F2 next frame. Even if you will press F3, so this will open up this current frame option. Then simply you can define, because if you are creating a clean page, so this current frame is very important frame, because again and again you have to go to on your frame where you are creating your clean page. So for this one also I have defined a shortcut. So these are actually basic shortcuts for our this timeline. Then next some actually preferences setting. Then again we can click on edit. Then we can click on this preferences general. And one important preferences in performance, just we can define our history. So according to your system performance, just you can define it here. So here I have defined 300. Maybe you can define 500 or 1000 here. Now click on OK here. Next I am going to see our this layer options here. So by default, if you will import any image sequence into Photoshop, so this will just create a layer with a group folder here. So this is our actually main group folder. Inside this you will get this video layer. So what we have to do before starting our paint work, we have to ungroup this layer, or we have to move out this video layer from our this group. So for this there are two options. First simple, you can right click on this group, then select this ungroup layer here. So this will actually ungroup this layer. Now press Ctrl Z. Then second option, simply just you can select this video layer and just move out from this group. Then you can select this group and just delete it here. So mainly there are these two options. So whatever you like, you can use this one here. So now we are ready for paint work here. So first here, just save our PSD files here, or this project file here. So simple, we can click on file, then click on save. Now click on save on computer and just select your folder, just in a proper folder. So here I have already created this folder in PSD file. Just double click here and just give a name. Now we have to click on save here. Okay, here. So now we are ready for paint work here. So first we have to create a new blank video layer here. So for this we have to click on this layer menu, then video layer, and just select this new blank video layer here. So now here if you will see in our this timeline, so this will start your this blank video layer from this frame, whichever frame 19 here, because your playhead is here. So here before creating your blank video layer, if you can just move your playhead at starting frame of this timeline, or simply just we can offset this video layer at starting. So like this, just simply you can pick with left mouse and just you can offset it here. So according to your timeline duration, you have to create a blank video layer here. So now here just type create over this blank video layer. So whatever we will do our paint work, we will do on our this blank video layer, not direct on our original plate here. So just rename it here, so they were original video or original plate. Now we have to start our paint work. So for this we have to use over this clone brush here or clone tool here. So simply just we can take over this clone tool. Now little bit just zoom over this viewer here. So simply hold Alt and middle mouse button and scroll. So here I have taken over this clone tool. Then after this we have to select our frame where you want to create your clean plate. So just, so suppose just I want to create a clean plate on frame 45, then you can select. So here suppose I want to create a clean plate, just simply we can select over this clone tool here. Then we have to take sample from here, so hold Alt and just take sample. Just simply we can click it here, then we can paint over there. Just try to paint it. So actually it's not doing anything here. So if you will see here, so if you have selected this clone tool, so on top you will get some settings for our this clone tool. So here this option, just we have to select current and below. This is most important things here while you are doing paint work on any blank layer here. So just we have to select this current and below. So now again just pick sample from here. So just hold Alt and just we can pick sample here. Now if you will paint over there, so it's just painting. Now you can see. Then this opacity, so according to requirement, just you can adjust your opacity, even flow also. So just make it here maybe 80. And if you want to adjust brush size, then simply press open and close bracket. So close bracket, this will just maximize brush size, or this will increase brush size. Then open bracket, this will just minimize brush size here. Now just paint here. So again, this is just only for explanation. So hold Alt and just pick sample and just we can paint it here. Like this we can paint. So remember this one guys, here I am not using any reference frame. just only I am picking sample from here and just painting over there. Okay, now again hold Alt and just we can pick and just we can paint over there. So this is mainly called just simple cloning here. So just we are picking sample from here and just we are painting over there here. So this is your first option. Now second, just I am going to explain. Suppose if you want to create a clean bed using reference frame. So this is actually main thing in Photoshop, how we can create a paint or how we can do sequence painting in Photoshop. So again, just delete this layer. So again, just create a new layer so easily we can understand. So this layer positions here. So again, just we have to pick and just move it here before start your paint here. Okay, so remember this one here. Now here layer I've selected, then on top just I've selected these options here. Because here just we have to create a clean plate on frame 45. First, suppose I want to remove this portion. So just we have to check where this portion is not available. So that will be our reference frame. This frame, which is our frame maybe 22. So this will be our reference frame. Because this is our reference frame, so first we have to pick our reference frame. So for this, simple hold Alt and just click here. So this will pick your reference frame. Then after this, we have to place your playhead on frame where you are creating your clean plate. So simply just double click here and just type it here 45. Now we are at frame 45 where just I am going to create our clean plate. Then we have to again take this clone tool if you have not taken. Then after this, we have to open our clone brush settings here. So for this, just simply we have to click here. So this will open over this window. So here first we have to uncheck two options. First this show overlay, second this clipped here. So both options just we have to untick here or uncheck here. So just uncheck. Now if you will hold Alt and Shift, so this will show you here reference frame. So hold Alt and Shift, so here you will get our this reference frame. So simply you can see. Now just simply we can match, so you can see. Now again release Alt, so this will show you here clean plate frame where you are creating your clean plate. And if you will hold again Alt and Shift, so this is actually reference frame. So with the help of left mouse, just we can match this one here. So just we have to match these two frames here, but this is a little bit difficult here because just at a time we are seeing only one frame or clean plate or reference frame. So this is a little bit difficult to match here. So for this, what we can do? In our this overlay, this opacity, make it here 50. So just like overlay in new course silhouette. Now if you will hold Alt and Shift, so we can see our both frame, which is moving, this is our actually reference frame, and which is static, that is our clean plate frame where you are creating your clean plate. So just we have to match our this reference frame with our clean plate frame. So now easily we can match it here. Just simply click here. So now here I have matched. A little bit just minimize here. So easily we can see. So again, hold Alt and Shift. Then with left mouse, simply just we can match. So you can see. So just we have to match all these things here. So just here I am matching this one. So because first just I am going to just actually clone this part here. So just here downside we have to match perfectly. Okay. So for this we can use some shortcuts. So if you will use left right arrow, so we can move our reference frame left to right. So then up and down arrow. Now we can see here. So if you are releasing Alt button, so this will actually showing here clean plate frame where you are creating clean plate. And if you hold Alt and Shift, and this is showing here a reference frame. Now if you will see here, so actually just position I have matched here, but some rotation we have to match here. So for this we can use shortcut less than and greater than. So simply just we can rotate our reference frame. Now just use, so you can see here guys. Now just I am simple, just I am rotating and just I am matching here. Now use left right up and down arrow. So just we have to match all frames. Now here rotation simple, just I am match. So here remember this one, I am holding Alt and Shift button. Then you have to use less than greater than for rotating our reference frame, and open and close bracket for scaling or for adjusting size of our reference frame. So open bracket, so you can scale down, and close bracket, you can scale up. So you can see here. Like this, you can adjust your reference frame size if there is any requirements here. Even in this panel, you can simply see, even you can type it 100 by 100. So just simply we can type it here 100 by 100. Now again, hold Alt and Shift. So with Alt and Shift, so first you have to use Alt and Shift, then you have to use all these shortcuts for adjusting your reference frames. So maybe now here this is just looking good here. Then after this, simply we have to reach Alt and Shift and just we can paint it here. Now just simply we can paint over there. So now here just I am using reference frame and just I am creating over this clean plate here. Now simply we can also for this. So again hold Alt and Shift. So you can see here which portion just we can paint according to this reference frame. So simple, if you can paint this one here, but not entire portion here. Okay, so now here just I have painted out this portion. Suppose here you have done something mistaken. Now just paint a little bit too much here. So how we can actually recover this thing here? So for this, we can take a eraser tool. Simply you can press E and just take this eraser tool and just adjust brush size with open and close bracket. And just we can again just erase it here. Even we can also recover entire things here like this. Then again, you can take this clone tool here. So here these settings you can use according to requirements here. Even this brush, soft brush we have to use here. So this hardness we have to make it zero. Remember this one here, okay? Or just simply we can again just paint it here and just we can remove this thing here. Now we are just creating this clean plate here. So same as we can select multiple reference frame and just we can remove this character from over this sort and just we can create our clean plate in Photoshop. So guys, till here I have completed about this class, basic tools and settings for VFX paint in Photoshop. In next class we will continue on same sort and we will create a complete clean plate using reference frame in Photoshop. So guys, if you like this video, please watch, share, comment and subscribe my channel if you are still not subscribed my channel. So thanks for watching.